wine still of the week. And what I want to focus on is wines at a value. Hey, what up, everybody? This is Jaytan Gunter, owner of Grapes of Sam Publishing. As you can see, there's wine in my glass, so I'll be doing a review. Welcome to another episode of Wine Still of the Week, where I go find a bottle that's under $20 that's punching above its weight class. Something that's hopefully local to you, whether you can purchase it online or you can go to a local store such as Total Wines, Grocery Outlet, places like BevMo or, just like all types of places that hopefully are a chain that are close to you. So that's the whole premise of the show. So welcome to another episode of that. And we're going to get right into it today. Today we are in Italy. You know how I love Italian wines. And we are talking about one of my favorite varietals of all time. We're talking about Nebbiolo. Nebbiolo. So this one is out of Piedmont, which is northern Italy. Lange area, which is where most of the great Nebbiolo comes from in Piedmont. And this is 2017. This is La Sacrestia out of Lange, Nebbiolo 2017. As you can see the label right here. Hopefully that's, you guys can see all that. And we're going to get right into it today. On the nose on this wine, so immediately I get this like macerated berry thing going on here. I'm getting like raspberry. I'm getting a little bit of a blueberry and raspberry thing going on here on the nose. So blue and red fruit. There's definitely like a spice here. A little like cumin. And then also like a kind of a hickory, like smoky peaty spice going on here. I'm also getting like kind of a burnt graphite. I would say like graphite has just been laid down, or street has just been laid down, and it is the sun has been beaming on it, so you get this kind of weird tarry smell. That's what I'm getting here on the nose. There's also a little bit of a floral aspect here too. I'm getting like kind of a dirty rose petals going on here on the nose. And a secondary, like, kind of a salty, like, salt, like, kind of saline, salty beach water. I don't know. I'm getting, like, a little kind of a salty edge, too, to this. All right, let's go ahead and taste it. It's pretty complex on the nose. This is very dry. Very dry on the finish. Starts off with that kind of wild berries up front. Leans more towards the raspberry than the blueberry that I was talking about on the nose. Tannins are medium plus, but not overly tannic. Like, it really melds well with the fruit. So this is really well balanced for our Nebbiolo. Nebbiolos can get really, really tannic, especially if we're talking about like specifically Barolo or Barbaresco. This is not that. This is very food friendly. This is a medium to medium plus body wine for Nebbiolo. Very approachable for a Nebbiolo too. Like, one you can drink by itself or pair with food very well. Even though this is 2017, it's a young Nebbiolo. This one is just like kind of delicate in a way. It's not overly tannic. The acid, I would say, is more medium plus too. This is a beautiful wine. It's very elegant. Long finish, kind of that spice and like kind of that spice definitely kicks in the mid palate to the finish, and stays there throughout the whole finish. That cumin thing you catch in there too on the third quarter to the finish. This is a wonderful wine. I highly recommend this wine. This is one that I want like pork chops with, or I could even do like kind of cheeses and meats and stuff like that. I think this will go really well with that too, because of the acid content. Like I said, it's like medium plus acid. Or even a burger. I think this would kill in a burger. This is a wonderful wine. Highly recommend it. Go get it. Where you can find it at. If you go to Total Wines. It's not at all Total Wines. But I know the one that I'm talking about is in Fremont, California. Total Wines. It's $18. And it's definitely a steal in my opinion. This is a highly recommended in my opinion. Go grab it. Go grab a case of it. Especially if you're looking for something to kind of drink. When it's warm outside, if you chill this a little bit, this would just kill, in my opinion. So go grab it. And question of the day: what's your favorite type of art? Do you like writing? Are you into like the painting type of art? Are you into like the musicians, like music type of art? What is the one that drives you? What is the one that you're when you're sipping a glass of wine? That you really enjoy to partake in or create yourself or just to watch being created. What's your favorite type of art? Hope you guys are having a wonderful week. I hope this is the perfect ending, the whole perfect bookend to your week. And until next time, guys, cheers.